My name is Peter, and I was diagnosed with AML in July of 2015. It started in 2012, actually. I was diagnosed with MDS, myelodysplastic syndrome. It progressed from there in January of 2015 to CMML1, and from there it went to AML in July of 2015 in the midst of a bone marrow transplant. The transplant turned out to be 11 weeks in the hospital, but there was a lot involved. As far as the transplant experience and the hospitalization, I was in the hospital for 11 weeks for both transplants. And as far to cope with it, I think the first thing I did is I'm able to compartmentalize, kind of think things through. And originally going in, I was told it would be a 6 to 8 week process. And so I was sort of resolved that this was going to take 6 to 8 weeks. Now, before I'd come in for the transplant, I was actually going to a caregiver group because my wife has cancer, or had cancer as well. And in that caregiver group, we had met a woman who had a stem cell transplant, and she was very helpful in telling me kind of what to bring. She brought everything. I guess she brought like 3 or 4 boxes worth of things. I didn't really want to do that, but I brought my computer, my music, my phone, some books, just things to keep myself occupied. I think I also knew going in that it was going to be 6 to 8 weeks of isolation, you know, in your own room. While I was there, obviously the nurses became friends and people to talk to every day. They encouraged you to walk a mile a day in the hallways. I didn't always do it, but on most days I forced myself to do that, and that kind of kept the monotony down. Watched a lot of TV. My wife, who has been supportive throughout the whole thing, visited every single day while I was there, and that helped me get through it. I really haven't sought out any kind of support groups for AML specifically. The group that dealt with all types of cancers was kind of my support group. There was one woman in this group who had gone through a stem cell transplant who was very knowledgeable and helpful to me in understanding what was going on. I have a very good friend who actually was diagnosed with lymphoma many years ago, and he had a 5-year journey with that, and so he was very helpful in talking on the phone and telling me kind of what to expect. And although his experience was pretty different than mine, but he was a good support.